A very warm welcome to all of you on the occasion of Mahaparinirvan Din. I, Aditya Madhav Deshpande, research scholar at Policy and Advocacy Research Center, here for a short talk on the economic and agrarian thoughts of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. In a present situation, lots of Chalo Dilli slogans are raising, farmer protests are going on, and lot of things revolving around the agriculture. So I thought to discuss on agriculture with regard to Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. What was his thought in pre-independence era of agriculture? So I will be discussing on following 5 points one by one. The first 5 points are land revenue. Second, I will discuss on state socialism and agriculture. Third one is the land holding. Fourth one is the abolition of khod system. And fifth one is collective farming. First one is land holding. Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar was the first economist who examined that the fragmentation of land and subdivision of land is very bad thing that is going to violate our Indian agriculture. According to Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, what problems our farmers were facing, such as means in this time also we are going through these problems. First one is low productivity, second one is high dependency ratio, fourth one is lagging in production, and at the last is the technical improvement. There are no technical improvements are going on in that time. So he always says that our country needs a cooperative and collective farming for revival of Indian agriculture. Then the second point is the state socialism and agriculture. Dr. Ambedkar propounds the concept of state socialism. In this concept, it envisages the collective farming, in which abolish the intermediary. First one, abolish the intermediary. Second, state should acquire the total land. Then this land should be divided among the farmers. Fourth one is farmers should produce collectively, means they have to do the collective farming, and while doing this, state should provide the essentials, means agri input, and after the production or after the selling of this produce, what benefit or what profit they are getting, it has to be divided among the farmers. So we can see what an vision Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar has on the state socialism and agriculture. Then third point is land revenue. He criticized the land revenue of British government because it is highly oppressive, and there is no justice and equality in this system. Why? Because Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar emphasized that the point is assessment of land is not on the growth of income, but it was on the ability of taxpayer or ability of tenant or ability of the owner. Means if you are able to pay 10,000 rupees, then you have to pay the tax of 10,000 rupees. But after the paying the tax, if he can run his own life or not in good lifestyle is totally not taken in the concern of land revenue system. So he told that the tax payable was enhanced with the growth of income. Then fourth one is abolition of the khod system. Then what is this khod system, and this bill, abolition of khod system, this bill is introduced in 17th September 1937 in the Bombay Legislative Council. दिस एबोलिशन ऑफ खोत सिस्टम वॉज प्रिवेल्ड इन रत्नागिरी रायगढ़ ठाणे देन वॉट वॉज दिस सिस्टम हु आर द खोत्स हु आर कलेक्टिंग द रेवेन्यू देन आफ्टर कलेक्शन ऑफ रेवेन्यू दे आर obliged to pay certain part of it to the British government but after some time they are not paying at the proper proportion to the British government or after the paying the proportion they are misusing that freedom they are exploiting the tenants farmers and landowners whatever and all type of exaction and exploitation was done by the courts so all this results to the poverty of tenants so dr baba sahib ambedkar introduced this bill in bombay legislative council at one point in that time there was three murders happen of khots and they are killed brutally so we can see the situation of that time the war or the strain between khots and tenants so to abolish the khot system and stop the exploitation of the tenants and create a direct relationship with farmer and the government see we are reading the these laws and we are watching the videos that they are saying the direct relationship with farmer to consumer means direct relationship how dr baba sahib ambedkar given to the india in the abolition of the khoti system then fifth one is at the last by linking up the land revenue land holding abolition of khoti system and state socialism we are came up with collective farming means from that time dr baba sahib ambedkar says agriculture is a state subject now we are saying that we are protesting on the topic that agriculture is state subject but dr baba sahib ambedkar told at that time that agriculture was state subject so he recommended that state should acquire all the lands and compensate the high land holdings or high land holders or the owners for their value of the land according to the following conditions what were the condition first is farm the farm was cultivated as collective farming according to the rules and regulations or directions issued by the government second one land was let out to the villages without distinction or discrimination of caste or creed or in such manner then third one is state is obliged to finance the cultivation of collective farms by supplying draft animals implement manure seeds or likely we can say lots of agri input what it may be then the tenants were to share among themselves the produce of the farm left after the payment of charges properly liable on the farm then in the fourth point a to the levy the following charges on the produce of the farm first a portion of land revenue they have to give the levy the second the portion to the pay the compensation to the landlord third a portion to pay for the use of capital supplied means state has not to give the free of anything means they will not enjoy any kind of free inputs or like that they have to pay for their they have to pay land revenue they have to compensate the landlords and they have to pay for their capitals what they are getting from the state then the b of course to prescribe penalties against the tenants who are violating the condition of collective farmings or working in any way prejudicial to the scheme of the collective farming so see on the Mahaparinirvan Din I want to conclude that five points was given by Dr. Baba Sahib Ambedkar and his thoughts on agrarian economy of our India